Hi, love. When I started my job here in France, the first job that I ever gotten, there was a woman around 40, 45 years old. Later on, when we were talking, she was like, oh, you in your 20s? I thought you were 32. Mind you, I was 22 at that age. I was really offended when she said that. And she really tried to play it off as like, I never guess people's ages. I'm so bad at guessing people's ages. And when she asked me how old I thought she was, you know, I wanted to say 60. And she was, yeah, I think she was 42. Yeah, but she was 40. I wanted to say 60. Because how dare you say that I look 30 when I was 22? How old do you think I look right now? No, that's actually a question. How old do you think I look right now? So, millennials are saying that we look older than them or older than we actually are.
Millennials look younger than who?
You.
And some of us are a bit angry, but we're going to contain our anger in this video and kind of explore that. Where is that coming from? And also how we view age in society at this current moment or this current political time, if you wanna, you know, be fancy about it. And there's obviously been a few theories in some articles, which I'm gonna get into. But first, I wanna start off with like my theories on why we as Gen Z look older than millennials or older than we actually look. My first theory is that we are confused as a people of how people are supposed to look, because we are using celebrities as examples. Some of the videos that I've seen, people are comparing Gen Z to Kylie Jenner because, you know, she's the average of what a Gen Z looks like. I mean, the oldest Gen Z right now, I suppose, is around 26 or 27. I'm not sure. What's annoying is how when people are talking about this, saying that, yeah, Gen Z looks older, they're using celebrities that have access to Botox and nose surgery, I don't know, but all these type of surgeries and products that they use to look the way they are, and then comparing it to average people like me, where it's like, no, maybe they look older, but the rest of us look pretty normal. But then people are comparing the normal Gen Z that are just minding their business to actual celebrities and then basing that as, yeah, you look older. Why? Why do you think that? Because you've compared me to Gen Alpha, who looks older than they actually are, and now I look older, you know? It's also the movies and series that people watch of where John Travolta is acting as a teenager. So I think movies in general media has really confused people on how people are supposed to actually look at their current age, because a lot of these teen series have grown adults playing in them, and then when people look at actual people in real life, it's a completely different vibe, you know, because I'm guessing they want older people to play so that they don't have to exploit their kids, because the amount of hours they can work differ and they're shorter, so they'll therefore get adults playing as teenagers. So I hear, allegedly. There's also this whole thing of older people looking younger because of, you know, the surgeries, all that kind of stuff. So you get, for example, someone like Jennifer Aniston, who is supposed to look 30 years old and therefore take the millennials in their 30s looking like Gen Z. But then we have Gen Z looking like themselves. But because the millennials are made to look like they are younger, it makes the Gen Z look the same age as them. Therefore, they are looking older. Yeah, that was a mouthful. Probably nonsense. But you get what I'm trying to say. And what's also interesting, like when you watch those montage videos of millennials in high school, they always looked more mature, you know? And maybe those movies that I'm talking about were pretty accurate of how they actually looked. They always looked more mature. And I just think that's like a generational thing. Like every generation always looks older. Like I think Gen Alpha as a Gen Z, they look older. So obviously millennials think that we look older. The previous generations thought the same of the next generation. But what I do think is a major component and why Gen Z specifically does actually look older is our aesthetics, our makeup, how we do our makeup. And the more we're progressing through the years, the more the makeup and the beauty standards is making you to look older than you actually are. in the beauty standards in the 2000s, where we were babies and the millennials were around in their teenage years, I guess, having a small petite body which looks youthful was the beauty standard, right? Therefore, they looked younger, you know, no bum, you know, just big boobs or something like that, you know, thin legs, all that kind of stuff. That all projects a youth, young person, of which right now it's more big butt, thick, all that kind of stuff, bust downs, all that, which makes you look older. You know, that's a body of a grown woman. That is the new aesthetic for everyone. You know, you're talking, I mean, you hear, what do you call them? Gen Alphas talking about Giat. I heard about that just recently. I was like, what does a 10-year-old know about Giat? But like, because that is the new standard, you get these teenagers wanting to have big butts. You have Gen Z wanting to have big butts, you know, which essentially equals a grown woman's body. So even if someone is 19, someone is 25, and they have that body style, you kind of placed in this category where you all together the same age and you are older. I think what also makes us look older is our mentality as well. I have to be biased with this because I think Gen Z is the most intelligent generations. Like, we are speaking up for so many things that have just been left unsaid. We are deconstructing structures. We are talking about capitalism at 18. We know all those things. So just us speaking, there's just so much things that someone of that age wouldn't know about. Like, I'm recently watching Friends, and the depiction of, there's this scene where Joey is pretending to be, you know, young, I think 18 or 20, and he's just like, the way he's wearing his clothes, the way he's just not self-aware, the way, you know, he speaks, you know, like a dumb jock, you know, of which right now, perhaps they are, but like, of which right now, Gen Z, even the coolest people, you know, or whatever, they still have that sense of acknowledging what's happening in the world. Okay, some, but like, we have this sense of maturity because we are choosing not to be blind of the atrocities that are happening in the world, what's happening to the children and the people of Gaza and Palestine. You know, that's happening, and we talk about these things. So that way, we're already seen as too grown or like too mature, and we look old because of the things that we say and the things that we care about. It's not just, you know, mundane things and stuff like that. Yeah, there is, you know, that part of just not taking anything seriously, but we are always understanding what's happening, like what's happening right now with Minaj and Megan Thee Stallion. Someone commented, like, what is actually happening that we are being distracted to talk about this? Like, just that awakeness that a lot of Gen Z has, it's really nice. And I think that might contribute to some people thinking that we look older because, I don't want to say the wisdom, but like, because of the things that we are interested in. Okay, now that I've said all my theories, you can comment down below what you guys think. But I'm just going to read from this article and what this person that wrote this article thinks. You know, the reason is, it says that millennials learned how to use good skincare techniques in their late teens and 20s. Gen Z may have overexposed to techniques and started using products incorrectly, causing them to age prematurely. A number of experts have revealed to Female. Aesthetic experts have explained that using love of vaping, exposure to blue light, and getting tweakments too young are a reason for celebrities and influencers in their late teens to and early 20s to look decades older than those in the past. And that's what I was saying. I'm just going to comment on the next part that, like, they're talking about celebrities, of which that's like 1% of the actual population of Gen Z. Like, the rest of us don't look like that. No one I know has plastic surgery. You know what I'm saying? In fact, we are always told that we look young. Every time I have on my little afro and go outside, someone's going to tell me I look 16. I promise y'all, maybe right now I don't, but like, most of the time I'm being told that I look like a teenager. And so are my friends. They have really young faces. So it's like, they really took, you know, Kylie Jenner being exposed, you know, showing her skin.
As an advanced aesthetic injector, I think the reason Kylie Jenner looks older than her age or overworked is her nasolabial fold area or her smile lines. When her face is at rest, it looks beautiful, but when she smiles or animates, the area on the side of her nose is widened or splayed apart. That's from filler that's placed too superficially. I think her lips are also a little overdone, but she does look better than ever.
As like, oh my gosh, Gen Z looks older and ran with it, where it's just not the reality really. But I do understand the whole vaping thing. Like a lot of Gen Z do vaping, and you know, things that aren't good for their bodies, which might make them look which make them look older than they actually are. And when it comes to prematurely using, you know, Botox and stuff like that, surgery, yes, it happens. But I think on more, you know, the people that are rich, you know, not the average Gen Z person who's really trying to pay off their student loans and also work at the same time, like, yeah. As millennials generally have a heightened awareness of skincare and diet compared to previous generations, often incorporating more holistic approach to well-being, this shift involves a greater emphasis on preventative skincare practices and focus on a balanced diet. What do you guys think of this statement? Because I just thought of like the girl dinner trend that happened, where a lot of people just sharing like random things that they put together to eat. So when I say that my generation doesn't eat very well, I can say we definitely try. I think sometimes when we go through life according to trends, because then there was a clean girl aesthetic, everyone's eating clean, you know, and then there is, you know, girl dinner, everyone's eating whatever they want. But like in real life daily, I just started now eating more healthier, because I found a way to find frozen vegetables that are good quality here. Okay, food in France is really good quality, but I found, you know, an affordable way, because I couldn't eat vegetables every time because they're expensive, you know, to keep on buying them every week. But now I got, you know, frozen broccoli, frozen mushrooms, a lot of frozen stuff that lasts for a long time, like at least, you know, for like 3 weeks, you know, and that's great. And that's been helping me eat healthier. But what I do think Gen Z is definitely trying to get their lives together. Definitely, I don't really have any millennial friends. Oh, I do actually. And okay, that's just them. But like over a vast majority, perhaps they do eat better, you know, perhaps they do know skincare better. They are older, so they know better. But as an individual, as a Gen Z, I'm always looking up ways on how to do things better, safely, and more healthier. And I think our generation is more like in research, like they're researching how to do their skincare properly. I'm a skincare enthusiast. I research things and talk about them on my TikTok, how to layer skincare, what you should use for this and that. That is why, see that, skin is perfect, okay? We got no bumps, okay? I have makeup on, but like, we're getting there, you know. So that's what I have to say about that. In conclusion, oh, and also when it comes to men or Gen Z men that look older than they actually are, they have to explain themselves in that one, because I really don't know.
Apparently Gen Z is like aging really rapidly.
It is mainly because of the stress. Come here. We live in a time nowadays where millennials look way younger for their age, while Gen Z looks way older for their age. If you don't believe me, I'm Gen Z. Get closer. I am Gen Z, and nobody ever believes me. When my mom and I walk out in public, people think that my mom is my younger sister. Right. When I tell people, oh, I'm going to go hang out with my family, they think I'm talking about my children. I don't have kids. Right. I'm talking about my parents. I'm still the child. Does that make sense? I'll put it to you like this. Zendaya is older than me. Tom Holland is older than me. That's, you know what I'm saying right now? There was one time I wanted an autograph from Dwayne The Rock Johnson. Right. I was standing for hours for this autograph. And when he walked up to me, I said, can you please sign this poster? It's for Jordan. Right. He then took it and put, dear Jordan, your dad is a great guy. He stood out here for hours and then gave it back to me. And before I can correct him, he looked at me and said, times were way more difficult back when we were kids. Am I right? And then he tapped my shoulder and left. Dwayne is 52. I am 26. What I'm saying is, so Gen Z definitely looks older. I'm not going to lie to you.
Maybe it is the vaping. Maybe it's because they are growing beards or something like that. Looking at looking at movies where there are millennials, like, they looked older too. Like, but then at the same time, it's like, who are we comparing them to, you know? Like, how, what is the perfect, you know, person that represents how a person's supposed to look at a certain age? Like, you really can't, like, there really isn't. Because, you know, when you look at a young black girl growing up, I had my boobs already. I had my, you know, my bum, my hips, all that kind of stuff when I was like 13, you know? And the same could be said about my mom when she was that young, you know? So it's like, it's a recurring thing, you know? There's really no way to judge. Like, people are different. People are going to have different diets. There's genetics that are involved, all that. But obviously, on top of that, there's, you know, what we do, you know, what we put on ourselves that makes us look a certain way. But in conclusion, let's blame a patriarchy. Yeah, that's what we can blame. We can blame misogyny. Yeah. But yeah, beauty standards are a heck, you know, they are not helping us at all. It's probably one of the reasons why this is even a topic, you know, because of the beauty standards where we see our favorite celebrities not looking how we wanted them to look. You know, like, for example, Kylie Jenner girl, she's what, 26 or 25? I think she looks like a 25-year-old girl. I don't know why. And she's a mom of two. I think she looks her age. Like, who are we expecting her to look like then, you know? But anyway, tell me what you guys think about this video. It's definitely an interesting one. And guess my age down below. See you guys next time. Bye.